Again, I wanted to welcome everybody to our exciting Thursday night Circle of Greatness Academy call, where we just have the awesome opportunity to come together to support and encourage each other. But even bigger, we have just opportunity to meet with some amazing, amazing entrepreneurs who are doing some awesome things, who are making moves, who are here to motivate us and teach us and share some tools with us. We'll have the opportunity to ask some questions. We have a super amazing guest that I'm going to let our founder, Nehemiah Davis, introduce. So I'm just going to introduce him. He is my friend. He is my partner. He is an amazing entrepreneur. Bigger than that, he is an amazing giver, and he has given of his time and his energy, and he drives me absolutely crazy with the Circle of Greatness Academy, constantly wanting to add more and more value, more and more things to this group. And I think that we all feel it. I see the numbers rising as we're as I'm speaking with people joining in, so everyone knows the value of, you know, what the Circle of Greatness Academy has brought to all of our lives. So I just want to introduce my friend, Mr. Nehemiah Davis.
Ooh, that introduction was fire. We might have a little competition coming. Listen, guys, I am super, super, super elated about tonight's call. Me and my guy, Reason Resells, is going to bring you nothing but fire. But let me tell you one thing about us bringing fire to you tonight. It's going to be it's going to be up to you for you to execute. I say it to everyone. Reezy, he says it. It's no shortage of information in this world. It's no shortage of knowledge. Like, anything you want to know in this world is on the internet. All you got to do is unlock your computer, hit Google, and type it in. But the lack of execution is the reason why most people will never become successful. It's the reason why most people will never make their goals and dreams come true. So if you're on this chat, I'm really asking you to execute. If you're on this chat, I'm really asking that you make a decision tonight that you're going to make sure every single thing that's said to you, you want to implement. You're not just going to be on another call just sucking up knowledge that you're not going to use. If you're not going to use this information, if you're not going to be inspired on this information, I love you guys, but I don't want to waste your time. You can go watch TV. You can go do anything else, but Reezy's spending an hour out of his precious time to share knowledge and jewels that help you become great, that help you get to the next level. I'm asking that we show our utmost respect to him simply by executing and making sure we're present in the moment. Before we get started, let's go over a little bit of housekeeping. For those who do not know me, my name is Nehemiah Davis. I'm the founder and creator of Circle of Greatness Academy, which is an online and in-person community created to inspire and encourage current and aspiring entrepreneurs. My main mission really is just to help people become great, help people make money, help people serve, help people just make an impact on this world. For those who don't know me, you know my story. I've been kicked out of high school, kicked out of college, dad been in jail since I was 2 years old. I've been fired from 10 jobs, and my life changed 8 years ago when I made a decision to take action over my life, and I never looked back. Have not been employed in the last 8 years. I know Reggie going to talk about it. This boy always talk about just getting people out of their 9 to 5. So I know today this guy's going to give gems. He's going to give jewels for you to do the exact same thing. So for those who don't know me, welcome to Circle of Greatness Academy. And I'm just super, super, super elated about this call, and more so elated that we got my guy Reason Resells on the call. So without further ado, I wish you can clap. I wish you can make some noise, but let's make some noise. Let's get excited for this man who's going to share some gems with us. This man came from food stamps to now had made over $3.4 million online. So you have no excuse of not becoming successful. You have no excuse of not being able to make the goals and dreams that you want happening in your life happen. Why? Because he's doing it. Why? Because I'm doing it. Why? Because Watch Me Amazon, The Posh Hanger, and so many other people is making money online. So if we can do it, you can do it. So today is going to be an encouraging call. It's going to be an impactful call. But more importantly, you better get your ink pen out. You better get your pen out. And you better get ready for the information that's about to be bestowed on to you today. So without further ado, I would like to introduce my guy, Reezy Resells. What's up, my brother?
Hey, what's up, Nehemiah? How you doing, man?
Hey, I'm good, man. I hope that intro was all right for you. I know you do a lot of video chat, so I hope that one was okay for you, sir.
Hey, that was great, man. I'm just a regular dude like you out here trying to do great things. I don't need much.
Listen, and let me tell you, Reezy, one thing I want to say, you keep saying trying. It's the difference between trying. You really doing it, man. You out here pushing it. And just about, I have at least 10 members in Circle of Greatness Academy who has implemented some of the things you and Posh have said, and now it's really making money online, and that's because of you. I'm starting an Amazon business solely because of you, Posh, and Watch Me Amazon. So I want to say you doing it, bro, and I just want to say thank you. So let's jump straight into it, bro. Give us a little bit about your story. Like, tell us who is Reezy Reza?
So, so I grew up in a poor family. My parents were both alcoholics and drug addicts, so they separated at a young age. Me and my brother lived apart. My mom ended up going to jail a bunch of times. My dad went to prison, so I ended up being like in group homes and foster care. And eventually, my aunt took me under her wing and raised me. And that's when I came to live in Santa Cruz, California. And my aunt was a thrifter. Like, I'm a second generation thrifter. She's a used clothing dealer. So when I was a kid, she used to drag me around to thrift stores, and I hated it. I absolutely never wanted to go in one ever again, which is hilarious. But flash forward, you know, I had some more trouble in my life. I was a bad kid. I went to juvenile hall, getting arrested, selling drugs at a young age. And eventually I ended up getting shipped off to Kansas to live with a family member. And that's where I ended up meeting my wife. And I actually had a kid, got married, dropped out of school, and started living on my own from age 15 onward so that my wife could continue to go to school and so that I could provide an income for my family. And just growing up, I was always a hustler, right? I was always selling candy at school. I was always I grew up by a free admission amusement park, so I was always running little hustles and scams because I never could ask my dad for any money, but I could pretty much hear the money at the amusement park, so I had to figure out how to get it, right? So Gary Vee always talks about his baseball cards, the boardwalk, and all the hustles I did and scams. That was my baseball card. That was my intro to business acumen, and then after that came selling drugs, and that was real natural to me. And then later on in life, after I had a kid and calmed down a little bit and I had started working the 9-to-5 and it wasn't for me, I was dying on the inside. My little brother actually found out about eBay right when it came out, and he sold everything in the house that my mom would let him. And so then we started selling even more stuff, and like something happened. For example, we sold he sold his Nintendo with all the games and controllers, and the guy that bought it, his name was like, for example, video game seller guy. So we looked at his account and we're like, man, homie sells a controller, a game, a Nintendo, or whatever. So we realized he was making money off of us because he sold it all in a lot. And so that's when we learned about breaking bulk, and we learned we could buy stuff on eBay in bulk lots and sell it back on eBay. I've always been an avid reader just because I was a bad kid or whatever. So I never went along with the program, like when I was in the group homes or whatever, and I would just be grounded all the time, like self-imposed exile. But they would let me go to the library, so I would read, and I was like in my room like some kind of evil genius, like, ah, ha, ha, you're letting me read, you know what I mean? And through that, I found I like Star Wars books, so I read every single one. Like every Star Wars book pre-1999, I read that book. And then one day, I was like, you know what, I got 15 of these, this certain collection of Star Wars books. I was buying them retail price right the day they came out. And so I let them go on eBay for a penny. I was already selling stuff on eBay, not like a lot or whatever, not making a living, just on the side. And unbeknownst to me, they sold for a ton of money, like 75% of the retail value. And that's when I really realized that books were worth money. It just didn't click to me, even though I was buying them retail or whatever, it didn't click to me. And then later in life, I moved back to California. Brought my fam back to California when my daughter was about 5, and started exploring, you know, thrifting, going to the Goodwill, going to thrift stores, and I came across people that would have barcode scanners. And so when I saw the laser, I was like, wow, those lasers aren't cheap, you know what I mean? Those are going to cost like $100 plus. And so I hit the internet, you know, I was trying to figure it out. There was no Reezy resales, you know what I mean? There was no tutorials on YouTube. There wasn't a lot of blog articles. There was like maybe 3 books that I read, and that was all there was. And no one would share any information. I couldn't figure anything out until one day. I just kept asking everybody that I saw, and everyone was real hush hush, which made me realize, hey, this must be a good opportunity if everyone's trying to be so secretive about it. And so one day I seen an old lady that I had never seen before, and she was scanning books. And I asked the same thing I always ask, like, hey, what is that app you're using? And she told me right away. She was like, oh, it's called a seller tool, which now is that was 11 years ago, so that was on a PDA, and now they have an iPhone app called FBA Scan, which is the app that I use or whatever. And so from there, I learned the app, you feel me, and then it was just madness, you know. That was like the start of me selling books, and I ended up quitting my full-time job maybe like 3 months later.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
It's a lot more than that, though. Like, everyone likes to say, you know, they don't have no options, no money to start out with or whatever. So, like, we didn't have no money. We were living check to check completely. I didn't have nothing. I didn't have any money to invest in inventory. And we had been, you know, going to food banks, you know, churches to get food and stuff, just to help us out. And then I was like, man, we need to go only to the churches. And then we even started eating at the homeless shelter. So I convinced my wife to take our family to eat at the homeless shelter. For 30 days, we ate at the homeless shelter and lived off of food bank, just so I could save that $500 a month from our normal food budget and be able to roll that into my Amazon business, which is what allowed me to start it off. And then 3 months later, I quit my full-time job.
Wow. The reason, like if you can quantify, right, how many people you think help start an Amazon business, what would that number be? If you can make a wild guess.
How many people I help?
Yep.
Thousands, I guess. I don't know.
Wow.
I know, at least 100 people have, like, a solid 100 people have quit their 9-to-5 because of me. And people, you know, like, I'm borderline cry about it because people are like, yo, Reezy, they'll send me a snap like, yo, I'm at Disneyland right now with the fam, and I paid for all of it off Amazon money thanks to you. I'm like,
wow.
What? You know, like, just yesterday I got a DM from a woman who said that she's just started, but she plans to crush it, and her goal is to be that stay-at-home mom that gets to go on field trips with her kids.
Wow.
And you know, that's amazing.
No, it's amazing. I think, Reezy, the type of people you are and who I am, you know, we don't really give ourselves enough credit, and we all our everyday life, we call this work. Like, you know, we just grind and we hustling. Everything we do seems normal to us. So you helping 1,000 people, 2,000 people, that's your job, right? And same for me. The reason, I'm going to tell you which changed my mindset. Years ago, you know, again, me being an African-American child, a lot of us go in jail. We just do a lot of different things. But at this time, I started a business. I felt like I was doing great. And I was telling my multimillionaire mentor, I'm like, listen, I'm doing this, David. I'm doing this. He was like, okay, that's what you're supposed to be doing. I'm like, what? You tell me all this hard work I'm doing, everything I'm doing, you saying that's what I'm supposed to be doing? And at this time, his son had a $1 million startup. He graduated from a prestigious law school. So now it made me understand why he said this is what you're supposed to be doing. So ever since then, I stopped looking at things that I was doing as an accomplishment. I started looking at them like, yo, this is what I'm supposed to be doing. I'm supposed to be helping people all around the world. I'm supposed to be traveling. I'm supposed to be giving back. I'm supposed to be living the life of my dreams. And I believe us living this lifestyle has made it seem like, yo, everything we do is average. But I do want you to really take a minute to think about the impact that you're really making on people's lives. You made an impact on my life in just a short amount of time. You're going to help us make a ton of money, help my peers make a ton of money. So I want to say thank you, and I don't want you to really take that lightly because that's major, man. That's a huge deal. So I want to say thank you once again.
I just got started, man. I'm not done yet.
Oh, I know, and that's the attitude. That's the attitude that's going to make you a billionaire.
This whole thing, I gotta figure it out right now, but hopefully you can help me with this. But I want to reach, you know, like, it's cool to reach the people that want to know about selling stuff and the people that already found out about Amazon, you know. But I want to reach the people that don't know that you can sell on Amazon and eBay. I want to reach the people that don't know you can make $100,000 a year selling junk from garage sales on eBay. You know what I mean? If you're willing to put the muscle in, you can do this. You know, I was listening to a rap song the other night, and it said, Something, homie lost his job, kids got to eat, now he's got to rob. No, he doesn't got to rob. He can sell on Amazon. And I want to reach, you know, those young kids, that my young self that was selling drugs when I was 12 years old. You know what I mean? Like, there's 12-year-olds out there selling drugs that have more business acumen in their pinky than people who have graduated with bachelor's degrees in business, and they don't even realize that they know, like, 80, 90% of the game already. And, you know, like, man, there's so many people that need to know about this, and then, like, aside from selling online or whatever, that would be like the step one, right? Like you could take that and you could free yourself and buy your time back. You could watch me Amazon and do a $10 million a year business, or you can do whatever you want. If you're happy with $50,000 a year, $75,000 a year, $40,000 a year, whatever, and then you can follow your passion. Like once I started, I thought I was starting this to teach people how to sell online, which I am, right? But that's just the first part of the journey. Once you free yourself from the slavery of the workforce, the 9-to-5, because we're all gods, right? We're all out here. We can all do great and amazing things. Society has brainwashed us to believe that we're average and that we're not great. You know what I mean? Everybody can do something amazing, but not if you can't, you know what I mean? You're selling out all your best hours, 9-to-5. That's your best, most awake, alert hours. When you're a hustler and you get off that 9-to-5 and you work for yourself after that, you're a true hustler, because it's not easy to work those extra 8 hours. Those are not the easy hours to work. You done sold off your good ones already. You know what I mean? So I want people to know, man, you can once you get your time back, you know what I mean, you can then start looking for the passion in life and then start doing great things, whatever that is, and giving back to the world or whatever. But it's like, I know exactly how everybody feels, because I grew up like 7 years old. People would say, hey, you could do anything. And I would be like, yeah, right. That's just something you say to kids. You know, I was jaded from a real young age. But now that I'm a little bit older and I've been doing this social media for a year, I realize you can do anything. And social media is the way you're going to do it. You know what I mean? And it's like, I realize it's so clear to me now that there's no way you could not succeed if you truly give yourself to something that you want to do, especially if you're utilizing the tools that we have nowadays. Like, this, what are we doing right now? This is crazy.
Yo, crazy. You in California, I'm in Philly. We giving the game, bro. Listen, guys, man, this guy is giving the game right now. Listen, before we even go any further, I know I read you say smash the like button. I want you to smash. You need to share this information. Get someone else on the call. We didn't even start giving the strategies yet for you to get some money. If you got a minute, put it on Instagram, text somebody. You need to get someone else on this call, because we're about to go all the way in. We're going to give you strategies to get paid. And like Reezy is saying, this boy plan on getting a lot of more people out of their 9-to-5 this year, and I'm with him. Me and Reezy had a conversation last night about us personally wanting to help 100 youth start businesses this year. You know what that'll do for them and their family? So our main mission is really about serving people and really wanting to see people succeed. Like he's saying, we are all put on this earth to be great. I tell people, you weren't put here to be average. You were put here to be awesome. You weren't put here to do just enough. You were put here to do more, and you had that. You have it in you. But you got to tap into that thing. You got to really go hard, man. And I really ask that you stop talking with your mouth and start talking with your feet and put the work in. Because there's nothing that you can't have. Reezy's a prime example. Man going to make over $1 million this year, and he's still saying, yo, I'm not doing nothing, bro. I'm just getting started. That's that attitude that you got to have if you really want to be great. That's that attitude you got to have if you want to be a millionaire, a billionaire. No, it's nothing. You're not exempt from anything you want in this world, as long as you're willing to hustle, grind, and put the work in. So, Reezy, let's get straight into it. What does it take to start this business and scale a business? So, I know we got people on this phone call who have not started, and then we got people on this phone call who already started. So, let's get straight into starting, as deep as we can.
Let's do it. So if you guys, the first
thing. Hit your pins out. Hit your record button. Y'all better do something right now. We're about to get a game. Game time.
So the first thing that you guys want to do is sign up for an Amazon seller account, right? So go to Google. A lot of things are going to start at Google, like Nehemiah.
Number one.
Type Amazon seller account. Sign up for an Amazon seller account, right? You're going to have to link your bank account to it. You're going to have to do all that jazz. Then you're going to want to download the Amazon Seller app from the App Store. It's a black Amazon app. Get that one. Then you're going to want to go back to Google, and you're going to want to search for hold on a sec. So there's a few things to it. I don't want to get ahead of myself, so we'll just take it simple right here. So once you have an Amazon Seller account and you have the Amazon Seller app, you can scan things with the app by using your phone's camera. So what you want to do is shop your house, and that means go around your house and scan things that you have in your house that maybe you don't want it anymore, or you don't need it, or maybe you're going to keep it, but you're just going to scan the barcode so you can familiarize yourself with the app. So scan stuff around your house, you're going to do two things. You're going to learn how to use the app to find things that are profitable. And the second thing you're going to do is you're going to actually find things that are profitable to sell in your house that you didn't know were worth money, that you no longer need, or you haven't used it for, you know, 3, 6, 12 months. You know, this is, it's not just Amazon either, guys. So a lot of the stuff that you have in your house, you know, it's not going to have a barcode. And so you're going to have to look it up by title or model number, or you're going to have to go on eBay and do a title search. And then on eBay, it's a little different. To do research on eBay, you have to have an eBay account, and you got to look at the completed sales. Those are going to be the green ones, not the red ones. Those are sales that didn't complete, the sold items, the green ones. And then that's how you can gauge what something is worth or what it might sell for or whatever. So for me, I mostly sell books, CDs, DVDs, media. And books are a great way for people to get started in Amazon. There's a lot of ways to run an Amazon business, but I recommend everyone to use books as a launching platform. The reason why is because books are very, very cheap. You can pick up some books and you can make a great ROI, 1,000% ROI. You can regularly buy a book for $1 and sell it for $10 or more. The best part about that is because they're cheap, you're going to get to learn the system for cheap. If you make mistakes, they're not going to cost you a lot, right? So, and if you want to push books all the way, you could do 1 million in books. You could do bulk books where you get truckloads of books, or you could just go around to thrift stores every day and cherry pick books. You can go to garage sales. The app that I use to scan books is called FBA Scan. It's a major key. So you can use this app to scan things other than books, but for books, the main thing with books is that most books aren't worth anything. So for books, you need to scan them as fast as possible, which means you're going to want to get the database mode of FBA Scan, which costs $40 a month. Now, what that means is that you download the entire Amazon catalog into your phone so that when you scan an item, it takes about a half a second for the data to come back versus maybe 3 to 5 seconds if you're waiting for cell phone signal on live mode. And that's if the place that you're at actually has cell phone signal, because you get caught in a basement one day or whatever and you have no signal, you know, you're going to wish you would have paid that $40 a month because one book, you know, is going to make you your money back or whatever. So then you're going to have like a little Bluetooth barcode scanner. They're super small, like the size of your key fob that unlocks your car or whatever. You can get them for $50 refurbished from me when I have them in stock. I haven't had them in stock for a few weeks. I should have some soon. You can get them on eBay for $60 or $75. The model I use is the Kometac KDC200i. That's Kometac, KDC200i. And like I said, $50, $75 or whatever. It's a Bluetooth scanner. It acts just like a keyboard. So when you scan the barcodes, boom, the number goes right to your phone versus you having to use your phone's camera, and it's just way more efficient. A cool little trick I like to do is Velcro the scanner to the back of your phone. That way you can hold it with one hand and scan stuff and then use your other hand to fan the books off the shelf or whatever. Another thing about Amazon, if you don't sell on Amazon at all, there's two ways you can sell on Amazon. You can sell fulfilled by merchant or fulfilled by Amazon, which means fulfilled by Amazon means you send everything to Amazon and they store it, and when it sells, they ship it using their whole system and they charge you storage fees or whatever. Merchant fulfilled means you have it at your spot, and when it sells, you go get it, you wrap it, and you sell it, send it off to the customer. We do 100% fulfilled by Amazon, and it's actually what I recommend people to do, but you should do merchant fulfilled first before, so you can learn the game, you know what I mean? You don't want to send a bunch of stuff off to FBA, your first shipment, and realize you made a huge mistake and that's all trash, because it's going to cost you to send it, it's going to cost you to store it, and if you make a mistake, it's going to cost you to throw it away. So just make sure that everything is going good. You know, baby steps, right? So take it easy. And it's real simple, guys. You scan stuff, whether it's a book or you're at Target or you're at Walmart, you scan stuff, and then the app will tell you on the screen, you know, what the lowest price offers are, as well as the sales rank. Sales rank is how you tell how fast something will sell on Amazon. It's literally the number that means how well it sells. So the number one sales rank in book, that might be like Harry Potter or something, you know what I mean? The number one chapstick, you know, that's probably selling like 500 chapsticks a day. I don't know. But yeah, you just scan stuff, and then it tells you what it's worth, the miracle of technology, and then you pile up your treasure, and you go home and you make shipments using Amazon's interface, and you mail it off to them at about like 20 to 50 cents per pound inbound shipping rates. And when the stuff sells, it just goes to your customers in 3 to 5 days, and everyone's happy, right? And the other thing is, you can sell it for a premium price. So I have Amazon Prime. I don't buy anything that's not Amazon Prime because I'm not waiting around who knows how many days for some, you know, random person, unprofessional item to show up, and then it shows up and the packaging is all messed up and I can't give it as a gift or whatever, you know? So my time's due, you know, and everyone's like that. So you get a premium, you know, 25, you know, I actually make money buying books off of other sellers on Amazon that aren't FBA, and then when they send it to me, I send it back to Amazon and make it FBA and then sell it for a higher price. You see what I'm saying? Like, there's a software that we use called eFlip. It's an online book arbitrage software. If you go on my YouTube channel, there's a whole bunch of links or whatever, and that's one of the links in there. And basically what it is, it's just like a scraping tool that grabs the whole Amazon catalog and gives you all these little tools to search it. So instead of like having to look on Amazon, you can say, show me all the books between this rank and this price and that price. And because they've scraped Amazon's catalog over time and have all the data, they can do that and then return the results to you. And then you go and look at them on Amazon and go, okay, I can buy that for $5. And when it gets to me, I'll be able to sell it for, you know, $50 during college textbook season. Because a lot of people don't understand that the whole thing with textbooks, you know, really you shouldn't try to sell textbooks when it's not textbook season, because the supply is so large and the demand is literally non-existent, right? So that's like another huge thing that we do, is buy and sell textbooks. Buy them in the off season, hold them, price them high, send them to Amazon, and then sell them in the textbook season. But really, I mean, it's not... You know, it's not hard, guys. It's really simple. The hardest part about it is just waking up and putting the work into it every single day.
It's crazy. It's crazy. I was speaking to Fox. I was like, recall. Hold on, let me. All right, I was doing a little echoing. So I was speaking to Posh. She was like, yo, listen, making money on Amazon is so easy. I'm waiting for Amazon to call me up to tell me, like, this is illegal. You can't do this anymore. It was so easy for you to make money. She's like, Neo, I'm just waiting for them to, like, yo, you can't make money. And this funny thing, shout out to my guy Shane, if he's on the line, someone I grew up with. He's like, bro, I just gave him my full-time job. I've been a full-time Amazon seller the last year. Spoke to him last night. So people are really out here turning in their 9-to-5, saying, here's your job back. Let me get my time back, and then let me go out here and hustle. And the thing I tell people every day is, your hustle, like my mentor E.T. says, we kill what we eat. Like, as entrepreneurs, Reezy, we're full-time entrepreneurs. If we don't go out here and hustle every single day, we will not eat. And I tell people that all the time. Don't come in this lane thinking it's sweet, because we don't only work a 9-to-5. We work from the time we wake up till the time we go to bed. Even if that means just working social media, we're working. So yeah. I want people to know, don't just trade this life in if you're like, yo, I'm trying to do this for freedom. No, because some weeks I work 80 hours, some weeks I work 30. It really depends.
It's so real, man. It's not a joke out here. Like, it's for real. Like, my wife is finally coming to terms with it, but it's like, for real, I don't drive anymore. If we're going somewhere, she drives, because that time is so valuable for me. I could answer 2 hours of DMs, you know? Like, for real, like, people don't know. I answer 2 hours of DMs every single day. For the last year, I've been helping people direct message 2 hours a day plus video chat, Snapchat, whatever. And it's just like, when I first started doing it and all, you know, she'd be like, well, you're on your phone. And I'm like, I'm working. You're like, yeah, I am on my phone, but I'm working. I'm not using Instagram the same way you're using it. You know what I mean? I'm not consuming content. You know what I mean? I'm putting content out there. And I'm engaging with people, you know what I mean? So it's like, if I was on Gary V today, I wouldn't know until someone texted me and told me. I don't watch Gary V, you know what I mean? I catch him on my feed when he gets me, when I happen to be there, like answering DMs or whatever, and I'll see like a little 2-minute clip, you know what I mean? But you're crazy if you think I can keep up with that volume of content.
Wow. That's crazy. Really quickly, guys, I got a question. If Devin, if you can answer me, because I know you're on here. How's my sound? My fiance messaging me saying I sound bad. Reezy, you hear me good, correct?
You sound good.
Okay. And Davida, how's my sound? I want to make sure I'm sounding good. I'm hoping that
it sounds good to me.
That isn't from everyone. All right, good. Everybody's saying solid. Listen to me, guys. For those who just called in, I advise you to download the app. Get inside our message box. Like, they're dropping questions in here. We're dropping questions. So get inside of the message box. That's where the real game is. So for those who call in, that's good. You need to hang up and get on the app so you can be watching this live on video, because I'm going to do some screen sharing soon. You need to be a part of my screen sharing. And as well as Reezy going to be asking some questions out of this chat. So, Reezy, let's hop back into it, man. I know earlier when we talked, we said we're going to talk about RA, which in these terms, I said, Reezy, what you talking about, bro? He said that's retail arbitrage. So we're going to talk about what retail arbitrage is and how you can instantly start making money doing it. I know Reezy be out there killing it making this money, guys.
So technically what I was talking about, buying books at thrift stores or whatever, that's retail arbitrage, but it's untraditional. Those are used books or whatever. So technically what people say when they say RA, retail arbitrage, they mean going to big box stores like Target, Walmart, Home Depot, grocery store, Safeway, whatever. Like, hey, you can sell groceries on Amazon, guys. A lot of people don't know that. But you know what I mean? So you go and you check out the clearance, you know? You check out, it's not always clearance, sometimes it's full price stuff, sometimes it's limited stuff, you know what I mean? If you ever try to get a certain toy for your kid for Christmas and you couldn't get it, I'm the reason. I'm the evil guy that bought the toy that you couldn't get, you know what I mean? I got all the Last Action Heroes. No one else got them, just me. So, mostly, I've been doing a lot of shoes in the last year because I just discovered, like I was Christopher Columbus or something, reselling shoes. And shoes are great for me. I can make much more per like minute of my time than with books. So if I have to choose between shoes or books, I'm going to source shoes or apparel. I like to buy stuff at Marshall's or Ross or outlet stores, Nike outlet, Adidas outlet, Converse outlet, Vans outlet, like wherever you could get stuff for really cheap, and it has barcodes, right? So you scan it, and if you're restricted to sell it on Amazon, maybe you got to flip it on eBay. If you're not restricted, then you could sell it on Amazon. Just to touch on that real quick, a lot of brands and categories are restricted on Amazon, and so unfortunately, some of them like Nike, for example, you can't get into it, and the only people that can sell Nike are older sellers like myself that were grandfathered in that had sold Nikes before a certain period. Also, CDs are gated. It's nearly impossible to get into CDs. I haven't heard anyone do it. And it's the same thing. If you would have sold a single CD before like June of last year, you would still be able to sell CDs. So it's kind of this thing where you want to sell something just so like if it does get restricted, you can have the ability to sell it later on down the road. But so there are a bunch of categories that you're not allowed to sell in when you make a brand new account that you can get approved to sell in, but you need to be a pro merchant to an Amazon pro merchant seller to be able to request approval for those categories, and that costs $40 a month. So the thing is, though, is that if you're not a pro merchant, they charge $1 per order extra. So as soon as you become a pro merchant, they drop that $1 per order. So if you're selling 40 items a month or more, you're breaking even or saving money by being a pro merchant. And then once you're a pro merchant, you can request approval in categories that you can't sell in as a new seller. So literally just sign in if you're a pro merchant and then Google category approval Amazon. And the first link should be all the categories you can apply for. Go through one by one and apply to every single category. Many of them will approve you right away just by answering a few questions. The ones that ask you for invoices, skip those ones until later for revisiting. You maybe want to put some time into getting approved for groceries or health and beauty or another category, which is going to require you to land an official wholesale account with a distributor so that you can get invoices and get approved. You got to dance with Amazon, guys. It's not like eBay where you can just take something and sell it. You know what I mean? To sell on Amazon is a privilege, right? Like, I mean, selling on eBay is a privilege too, but I think it's more of a viewed of as a right. Whereas Amazon, if you don't play by their rules, they're just going to kick you off right away. It's not, you know, I'm going to try and pass these dented products off as new. You know what I mean? You don't do that. You know, you can make so much money, you don't want to risk your Amazon account for anything. I kind of lost my train of thought there.
No, it's good. No, that's good, Reezy. I'm happy that you touched on that. Really quickly, what I would like to do, Reezy, if that's okay with you, as we go back to that, we're giving the game out. I want to answer a couple questions in our chat box. This question is from Amanda. She started selling after the Posh Hanger call, and now she's in your group. She loves it, and your private face. She's a Reezy ninja, as you would call. She's nice. Out here hustling, bro. And I love. And she also sent me some questions, so she got questions for you. But this one is Reezy. Can you explain how to get a reseller permit or a resell certificate?
Yeah, for sure. So it's different where whatever state you're in, right? But I'm in California, so I had to contact the Board of Equalization, and you need to register your business. And then once you register your business, then you can submit your whatever number they give you. It's different for each state. You could submit that number to get your reseller certificate, your tax exempt, your DBA, all that stuff. Really, they have a lot of resources for that. So just get on Google and look up your state government website for that, and they should have some kind of small business resource, like totally free. You just call them and they'll help you walk you through it. Because I remember when I set mine up, it was a little tricky. It was like 11 years ago or whatever, but they'll help you. You know what I mean? Their job is to make sure that people can start businesses in whatever state you're in, and to make sure that the state is able to collect their money. So they're going to help you. But in California, it's the Board of Equalization. I don't know what it is where you're at.
We'll find it out. We'll find it out. Amanda, once we find it out, we must share that information. Okay, what else we got? Okay. Reezy, so it's crazy, man. My man was just talking about groceries. When you say groceries, what would be some good groceries to? And how would that work if items are perishable? So when you say groceries, I'm somewhat confused.
So non-perishable grocery items. And only a certain time of the year, the non-hot part of the year, for the meltable items like chocolate.
Gotcha.
And if, I think if you sell candles too, they can only be in the warehouse during the non-hot part of the year. If it's non-perishable, you can send it into Amazon and sell it. Obviously, you need to get approved to sell groceries first, which would require a grocery wholesaler, and you order some stuff and get some invoices. But, I mean, the first thing that comes to mind for me is, like, organic products, gluten-free products, low-sugar products, all these types of products, you know, like, certain cultural food products that you might not have in every grocery store in America, right? But everybody has a mailbox, and so they can get whatever they want on Amazon and have it delivered to their house. You know, not every store has, you know, not every city has an ethnic store for every culture, you know what I mean? Or like, you know, today I saw Oreo just came out with like their competition to the Cadbury egg. So it's like an Oreo egg with Oreo filling inside of it or whatever. I guarantee those are going to go hard because it's a new product, and Oreo goes hard. You know, we just flipped a whole bunch of those Oreo Big Crunch bars when they first came out because they were super hyped and not everyone could get them. Every Easter, you know, after Easter's over, I'll go and buy the clearance Reese's Easter eggs. And I think they're like 2 for $5 on clearance usually or whatever. Then send them into Amazon and sell them for like $12 or $13 a pack, you know what I mean, and make like $4 on each one, which might not seem like very much, but, you know, you're like doubling your money or tripling your money, and you get a whole cart full of them, you know what I mean? You fill a whole cart full of Reese's Easter eggs, 500 of them, and then the cashier is like, whoa, you got a sweet tooth, and you're like, yeah, whatever, buddy. And but you know what I mean? It sells quick. It sells quick. Like, you wouldn't believe it how quick stuff sells on Amazon that people want, you know, like Christmas trees selling in July. I don't know why, but you know what I mean? Like,
and it's crazy, Reezy. When you say two things, 500 of something, 500 times four, you're talking about, and you potentially selling that within a month. I'm just making this up. $2,000 profit.
Yeah. Faster than a month. And that kind of thing
happens. That's somebody's monthly salary, $2,000 after taxes. That's good money.
It's ridiculous, man. And so here's another one, right? Like, this is a good actionable tip. Tonight at midnight, the Nintendo Switch comes out, right? Best Buy, Walmart, Target, whatever. Find out what stores you have at midnight. They should be having a release party. They should have some units on hand. My guess is there's already a bunch of people waiting in line at everybody's store everywhere, but some of these stores aren't going to have lines. Some of you are going to be able to get off this call with us and then go wait in line and go get you a Nintendo Switch. And I predict those are going to sell for minimum of $100 above retail price tomorrow morning when everyone wakes up and realizes that they can't get one. $100, $200, $300 more than the retail price. And it's going to be easy. You will post that on Facebook Marketplace or on Craigslist or OfferUp or Let It Go. You don't even have to give Amazon 15%. You could sell that locally. I guarantee you post it on your personal Facebook and you will have a personal friend whose kid really wants it. And, you know, they knew it was coming, but people, they do not act. They do not take action. You know what I mean? You know it's coming. You know it's going to sell out. It always sells out. It's Nintendo. And you wanted it, but you're going to wake up in the morning and you're just going to see video left and right, news update, Nintendo, Nintendo, Nintendo. You're going to have it.
So basically what he's saying is, guys, I'm about to go through. Hey, Devin, you got to mute the phone, Devin. You got to mute the phone. Basically what he's telling me I'm about to go buy me some Nintendo Switches, guys. And look, you know what's crazy, Reezy? What's so crazy about it is if they don't sell, you can return them. It ain't like you can't get your money back.
Boom. Exactly. There's no way it's not going to sell.
Fire up the car, Nintendo Switches tonight. We need to buy them out.
Yeah, there's no way it's not going to sell. No way.
Wow. Listen to it. We got 80 people on this chat. He just gave a game to somebody. If I don't make it, I need to know at least one person is going to go buy that Nintendo Switch and flip that bad boy tomorrow.
I live in a small surf town in Santa Cruz, so we don't get a lot of stock of that kind of item. You know, like when the Nintendo Classic came out, my homie in San Diego, you know, he's like, oh, we got 50 at my Target. I got 20 of them or whatever. And I was like, dude, we had 4 at my Target.
Right.
And the employees took all of them.
Dang. Reezy, I know our time is going by. You got a little bit more time, man? You give
us what's time?
No, I was just saying, you know, I don't know, you know, you might got to get off the phone. So, all right, what else we got? Let's hop into a couple more questions. This is another question that Amanda prepared for me. We already talked about the resources you absolutely need. You need to sign up for an account. You need to get the FBA scan. You need to get the Bluetooth. What else we got? What does it mean to be gated, and how does one get ungated?
So, gated means... it just means that you cannot get into that category to sell. So some categories are gated forever. CDs, gated forever. No one's been able to get into CDs since they shut it down. DVDs over $25, pretty hard to get into. I've heard a couple fairy tales of people getting into it, but not a lot. And let's see. Then there's two levels. So there'll be a category gating, and then there'll be brand gating. So, like, shoes are gated, and you can get into shoes, but once you get into them, you still can't sell Nike or Adidas. So those are brand restricted or brand gated, whatever you want to call it. So some of these things you can apply to get ungated. Usually they want invoices, and the only surefire way to do them is to get – actual wholesale accounts with suppliers and get those invoices. So,
gotcha.
You know, if you want to get a wholesale account with a supplier, don't tell them you sell online. They're not going to give you an account. Most wholesale suppliers do not want to deal with people who sell directly online.
Hear that, guys? Do not share you sell online. You have a store or something. So that's the perfect question then. What are some of the things you have done to build relationships with stores and distributors? Like, how have you been listed with so many places with your company telling them that?
So what, basically, just get all, you know, fake it till you make it, guys. find someone to make you a nice website. It shouldn't cost you more than $100 or $200, and it just got, you know, pictures of a warehouse, couple forklifts, whatever, and boxes, you know what I mean, smiling faces, something super vague, and a number. And then you just start contacting places and sending out your birds, shoot out your emails. You know, it's the same exact email to every single one. Then when they come in, that's when the work starts. Every time an email comes in, you're talking to a human, and you have a chance to make a connection with them to get some products.
That's
Did you have
good.
Something to say?
No. Somebody was trying to come in, so that was
all right, cool. Yeah. So basically, you know what I mean? Then you got the response that came from you sending out the email contact. Then you have to curate that and make sure that it turns into a relationship with the supplier, because really, they want to sell products, and you want to buy products. So the only reason this isn't happening is you didn't do your job. So just do your job once they come back to you, you know what I mean? And then once you land these accounts, I'm sure Watch Me Amazon probably talked about this, but, you know, you get an account, you go through their entire catalog, and you check their inventory against Amazon to see what is profitable for you to sell on Amazon. Now, you can use software, you can do it manually, whatever. Now, here's the thing that a lot of people get caught up on. When you find a product that you're like, wow, I can buy this widget for $5 from this wholesaler, and I can sell it on Amazon for $20, whatever. I can make $2 or $3 profit, great margin on wholesale, right? And I could sell maybe 15 a month. You're not sure, though. But then when you go to order, the wholesale supplier wants you to order 500 units, maybe 1,000. I don't know. And so you might go and buy all 500, and then you go and list them, and you made a mistake, right? You're stuck with these 500 units. You have to work really hard maybe to liquidate them to get your money back or some of your money back or whatever. So don't do that. What you do is you get one or two or three or four of these units for full price from retail. So go and find these items in a retail store or on a website or on eBay or Amazon or whatever, and go buy it from someone else for full price. When you get it, send it into Amazon and sell it. You're testing the market. You're not doing it to make money. So you buy three or five of these items, you send them in, and they sell right away. So then you're like, huh, I'm going to try a dozen, a whole case. That whole case goes. So now, you know, you lost maybe $100 or $50, whatever. But you know how fast a case will sell. So now you feel much more confident in going in and buying, you know, 1,000 of this item versus, you know, you weren't really sure. You know what I mean? Because there's a huge difference from using some software and looking at it versus actually putting your money on the line and then watching it, you know, go or not go. You know what I mean? So whenever you can test something like that, it's always good.
You giving the game, bro. Like, I'm super pumped. Like, listen
I'm
to
glad.
Me. If someone don't go get off this phone tonight and go make some bread tomorrow, like, you giving it to us, bro.
Hey, for real, hold on. I want to do a giveaway real quick. Can I do a giveaway?
Oh, absolutely. You already giving it away.
I'm giving away more. So right here, this book right here, this is Ask Gary Vee. This is Gary Vee. Gary Vee is the man with the plan. He put my name on the map. I wouldn't be on social media if it wasn't for Gary Vee. I was brainwashed. I thought Snapchat was what kids did that their parents didn't want them to know. You know what I mean? I was brainwashed by mainstream media. And Gary Vee, you know, he brought me to the light. He taught me the power of social media. And really, man, I feel really similar to this dude. I resonate with a lot of things he says. And a lot of you, if you don't know Gary Vee, you don't follow Gary Vee, you could learn a lot from the man. He does have a potty mouth or whatever, but if you can get over that, the passion and the flames that this guy spits are, like, unreal. Like, ask him a question, the thing that he says is amazing. It's just, like, off the cuff and amazing. So I want, if you are on this call and you go and get a Nintendo Switch tonight, post that on Instagram, you with your Nintendo Switch, tag Neo, tag me, tag Gary, and then I'm going to find your picture and I'm going to send you this book. So the first one that I see, you're going to get a copy of this book.
Wow, major. Hey, Major Key. Hey,
yeah.
Reezy.
Gary Vee is about, Major Key.
Listen, Reezy, we got to talk it over with your wife, but I'm going to talk it over with my Circle of Greatness fan. We got to get you to Philadelphia, man. We got to get you here. I want a session with you, Philadelphia, with only my COGA members, though. I'm sorry, because everybody – oh, man. I want to get you to Philly within the next 30 days, Reezy. I don't know how we can make it happen, but, bro.
What's the pizza like out there?
What's the who?
What's the pizza like?
Pizza good, bro. Best pizza ever. We're going to take good care of you. So
let's do it.
We're getting it done. I know, Amanda, you're in for that. We're going to get you a Philly cheesesteak. We're going to show you Philly. When I bring people to the city, I show them nothing but love. So we're going to do this in the next 30 days. My man, P. Michael.
Hey, we're going to vlog it up, man.
Hey, listen, P. Michael, we got to get my man Reezy here in the next 30 days. Let's push that and put that on the agenda. So that's happening, Reezy. Believe it. All right, guys, next up, Reezy, let's see what else we got, Reezy. Let's see what else we got. Let's see. Let me go through my questions. All right. What is the most you have paid for a book? Or what is the highest return you made off of the book?
Okay.
I know this is
Yeah, I'm sorry. I buy books for maybe I don't know exactly the highest price, but I would say on average, on the higher end of books that I'm buying are around $40 to $50. These are going to be not books that I bought at a thrift store. These are books that I bought online using software. These are definitely textbooks that I know will sell the next time semester starts. And these are probably books that go for $250 new that I'm going to sell for at least $100, maybe $150, you know, once everybody panics and they haven't ordered. You know what I mean? No one takes action. They don't order their book till the last week before school starts. They got 3 days to get it. That's when I'm trying to sell it. And that's pretty much the higher end. I mean, I'm sure I've bought books for more, but the highest selling book I ever sold was a book. I bought it for $1, and I sold it for, I think, $700 or $800. It was a book about, the title was like, Inbreeding Horses for Superior Traits or something like that. It was something crazy about breeding horses, and it sold on the last day of the year, to a farm. So I know the person that bought this book, they probably wanted it for a long time, and they just paid $800 for it on the last day of the year because it was a tax thing.
Wow. $800, bro. That's crazy. From a book. You kidding me? Hey, guys, also, Reezy's on his live, so you can't miss this, Jims. You need to, I hope, please share. Like, I feel like we still, as Reezy said, yo, we just getting started. So get someone on this call, guys. We want to share the game with you. Get someone on this call, because we're giving the game away totally for free, guys. So let's see what else we got. All right, let's see what else we got. Some more questions. We got so many chats. Reezy, you got any questions in your live that you want to answer?
Let me hit a question. Hey, hit me with a question, Instagram. We're calling
Instagram,
on you.
Instagram, hit my man Reezy with a question. I got a ton for him, but I'm trying to give some other people some more opportunities to ask a question. Reezy, where can we find books at? We know we got Goodwill. We know we got Savers. We know we got Yard Sales. Any other good spaces?
Yeah. Tons of stuff. So a great way to source books is Craigslist. So people post stuff on Craigslist in the free section even, right? So, oh, here's a good one. So there's a website called If This Then That. That's a pro tip, just that website alone. It takes services and different websites and allows you to do things like, if Neo tweets, email me that. You know what I mean? If Neo posts a picture to Instagram, put that in my Dropbox or something like that. You know what I mean? So you could use it for a ton of things. But what I like to use it for is saved searches on Craigslist. So you could say, if a listing gets posted on Craigslist with the word books in it or in the free section with books or whatever, send me an email, send me a tweet, whatever. Then you could be right on it and get on those offers right away. A lot of times it's just college students trying to let a couple books go after the end of the semester or whatever. Another good way is just advertising, right? So maybe you're going to put out word of mouth, obviously, right? Don't be secretive at all. Tell everybody you know you're the solution for books. Don't let them think about you without saying books, right? And then the books will start coming to you. You know what I mean? So maybe you could get bumper stickers made that say, I buy books. You know what I mean? Cash for books or whatever. At Cash for Books, your city. You know what I mean? You could ask the college if you could put a banner up on campus near the end of semester. You could buy a Snapchat geo filter and drop that around the college campus during the end of the semester that had like, you know, a little stack of money on the image and said like, at Cash for Books, Philly, and then you run that Instagram, and they'll start DMing you after they see the Snapchat filter from playing with it on campus or whatever. Like, the books are out there, right? The one thing that I want to point out is that it's going to be much easier for you to do books in a larger city that has colleges, okay?
Philadelphia.
The larger the city, the better. The more colleges, the better. The higher the income level, the better. The higher the literacy rate, the better. Like, for real, go get on the internet and start looking up literacy rates, and then also start looking at medium incomes and start drawing little circles on the map, and you might be finding some good books in those areas, right? There's X amount of colleges. People make over $100,000 a year on average. Rich people throw away good stuff. You know what I mean? So, you're not going to find the best stuff for thrifting in the worst areas. You know what I mean? You got to go where people have expendable income.
Wow. There we go. That's crazy, man. This is crazy, Reed. What else? You got another question in that chat, Reed?
Let's see. Yeah, yeah.
In the meantime, guys, listen to me. While Reezy's checking out a question, this is what we offer here at Circle of Greatness Academy. We're offering you the game. Like, I got friends like Reezy who jump on a call. Watch Me Amazon, Posh, Andy Frisella, soon to be next Gary V going to come eventually, E.T. I have some of the best people around the world who's giving us the game for free. And this is why I keep telling people, get yourself involved with a network who want to see you grow. Surround yourself with people who force you to level up. Get around a group of people who only want to see you do well, guys. The reason why you're on this chat tonight, because you know the information that you want to get today, it can help you grow. It may help you get out that 9 to 5. It may help you make another $300 a week, $500, $1,000, $10,000. But you have to get the information. But more importantly, like I asked everyone tonight, make sure you apply it. So, again, whoever get that switch, I'm also going to give you a copy of my book. Reezy, also, Reezy, text me your address, man. I'm going to ship you one of these tomorrow. I got to make sure you get one also for you. So, guys, Step into Greatness Journal is my book, one of three of the books I created on my birthday 2 years ago. I'm going to give this away for free. Whoever go buy that machine tonight, I know I probably going to go buy one. In addition, if you sign up for Circle of Greatness Academy tonight and you get a yearly membership, I'll ship you a book, also another free book. So get in the game, guys. Get around a group of people who want to see you do well, because we really want to see you get this money and survive. Hit me with that next question from your group, Reezy.
I got you. From the book Skippa, he says on Instagram, says, what happens when you make an LTL shipment and it splits it into multiple shipments going to the same warehouse? Can you stick these on the same pallet? So, no. You got to follow the rules. But let me explain what an LTL pallet is. So when you ship a lot of stuff to Amazon, like Watch Me Amazon a lot, you ship on pallets because you get a much better per pound shipping rate. You already get amazing shipping rates with Amazon. Like I'm telling you, like Posh said, you feel like you're stealing. You're mailing out hundreds of pounds of stuff, and you're paying 20 cents to 50 cents per pound to send it to Amazon because they have bulk discounted rates with UPS. And it really feels like stealing. It's crazy. But when you go LTL on pallets, you save an additional 60% in shipping. I'm talking about going from like 20 to 50 cents a pound down to like 6 to 12 cents a pound on inbound shipping. And that's insane when you think about like when you're buying books. You might not think about that as a lot, but when you're buying books for a dollar, 16 cents, you know what I mean? That's 16% right there, you know? So that's a huge amount of money that you're saving off of your cost of goods, investment, return, or whatever, you know. So anytime you could shave off that those fees, you should, especially because we know that, you know what I mean, nothing in business is staying the same, you know what I mean. The fees are going to go up. It's competition's going to get more rough, you know what I mean. And so, like you were saying, the whole circle of greatness, man. You gotta be with a circle of people that want you to succeed so that when the game flops, you know what I mean, you know what the next hustle is.
You know what I mean?
I'm not going to be the last one to figure out the next hustle. I can guarantee that.
Wow.
There's going to be 1,000 people telling me about the next hustle.
Wow. Get with a crew, guys. Circle Greatness Academy. Click the link in my bio, man. I'm telling y'all. We try and get y'all there. Reezy, so I really love the fact that I got so many people – years of people. Oh, I don't want to share the game. I don't want to show you this. You freely give all this information up and never worry about competition. Number one, why do you do that? Because I want to get in the mindset of someone like you, because so many people don't want to share information and you freely get a game. And number two, I know we talked about why you do it, but share with us why do you get a game and really want to see people just, you know, in this 9-to-5 life and coming on this life of freedom. Tell us about it.
Well, to be like fully honest about it is I really didn't start it with like a plan. I didn't start this to sell a course. I don't have a course. I didn't start it to sell a book. I don't have a book. You know what I mean? I started this to help people because there was so many people in this game doing information sales in this field. They were charging way too much and they weren't providing enough value. And from my perspective of an expert, they were really amateurish. And so I just decided that, you know, at first I started out getting on Facebook and helping people because these gurus, you know, wannabe gurus, they would say, hey, well, you know, people would have a problem and they would say, well, you could join our course, you know what I mean, and get the answer right there. And I would be like, they don't need to join your course. They could just Google it here. Here's the link, you know what I mean, figure it out. And then I would get kicked out of that group. And it would happen left and right. Like, I'm kicked out of every Facebook book-related group. No one wants me in there because I dropped so much knowledge that, you know, their patrons were leaving their group and coming to me. I didn't even have a group, and people were messaging me, do you have your own group? Do you have a YouTube? I didn't have a YouTube, you know what I mean? And so I made my own group by necessity because I got kicked out of everybody else's group because, I mean, there's still a few ones that are cool that I'm not kicked out of or whatever, but basically for being too helpful. Because a lot of these gurus, you know what I mean, they want to tend their flock and their sheep, you know what I mean? They don't want you to really be successful. They just want to keep you like slightly engaged and possibly successful so that you can get into their next lead pages, click funnel, or whatever. And so basically just helping people, you know what I mean? And just because I was frustrated with how it was, and that was my driving force. And then I started realizing how much help I was providing people. And then, you know, I don't know, I love to talk to people. So when there's right now I could pick up my phone, I have like 500 DMs across a bunch of platforms. That's like crack to me. Like not that I do drugs or anything, but I am so excited, exhilarated with this. Like every day I'm getting messages from people saying that I helped them. And so I started to realize that maybe I'm supposed to do this. You know what I mean? So I started helping people. And at first, I was being a little bit more secretive than I am now. I didn't give away some, like, source here or source there. But, like, in the last year, I've grown so much as a person. And, like, I didn't even know who Gary Vee was before, you know, maybe 18 months ago for sure, less than 18 months ago. And then I didn't know who Grant Cardone was or anything. And so then I started to realize stuff like, wow, you know what I mean? Success is unlimited. I had been brainwashed into thinking that success is limited. You know what I mean? And I can't hear you right now. Can you hear me?
I hear you.
Okay, cool. You muted it. Anyways, I was brainwashed into thinking that success is limited. And as much as I thought I shouldn't, the more that I gave away the game, the more that the game came back to me. So, like right now, you know, I might sell a quarter million in shoes this year or next year. And I didn't even sell shoes last year. And I wouldn't have gotten turned on to that opportunity to sell shoes if I wouldn't have been doing the whole Reezy Resells thing. And it's like, I've earned the respect of people that make way more money than I do. And I've learned in the last year, just from earning other people's respect, so many different hustles and different ways to make money online. There's so many. There's people that I have taught, my friend RJ Martinez. I inspired him to quit his 9-to-5. He's hustling so hard that in less than a year, he's already teaching me stuff. He's coming back at me and teaching me Shopify, Facebook ads, and all this stuff. And it's like, I've always been a subscriber to that because I grew up super poor. I knew that I had a share. And I'm small. I'm 5'3", 125 pounds. So I was not only poor and didn't have anything, I'm also small. I'm going to get beat up if I try to take anything. So I had to learn to share because if you don't share, like I always had nothing. So when I had something, I had to share it because that was the only value I could provide to my circle of friends or whatever was share. And then when someone has something and you need something, you know what I mean? They're way more likely to share with you. You know what I mean? You make them look bad if they don't share with you. And that didn't all, like, really kick in for me or whatever, but through the whole social media, it's been happening. And now it's crazy, you know? Now I'm doing YouTube, and now I'm teaching people social media. You know what I mean? Now I got other YouTube creators asking me, how do you make that video? What software did you use? You know? So now I got to make videos about how to make videos. And now I started my podcast. And, like, Neo, you said you want to start a podcast, so I'm going to make a video about how to set up a podcast in 5 minutes. It was the video I wish I would have seen 2 weeks ago when I started my podcast. You know what I mean? So it's like I started teaching Amazon. I don't know what happened. I think I discovered my passion is just teaching. Like, this is what I'm supposed to do with this gift of gab.
Wow. So this is what I want to know. Listen. I'm not nice. So this is what I want to... Hello.
Hello.
All right, cool. Can you hear me clear, Easy? No echo?
Hello. Yeah.
All right, cool. Hello. So, shout out to my guy, Larry. We actually in DM, Watch Me Amazon. He just made a pledge. He's donating to the ski trip. So, guys, really quickly, I don't want to jump off subject. But this Sunday, where I come from, you guys understand, we come from nothing. And to be able to provide a child with skiing, major. So, our goal, last year, we took 100 kids skiing. Andy Frisella paid for, he gave us $6,000. He paid for $6,000. So this year we're super light. Like, our goal was 100. Now we're scaling it down to 50 just because it's short notice. So if anyone on this chat could donate, you know, check my website, NehemiahDavisFoundation.org. We would love it. Shout out to you, Larry, Watch Me Amazon, for just saying he's going to donate. I know Pa says she
would. Hey,
this is what I want, Reezy. I want to get you here in 30 days. I want to get Posh here, and I want to get Watch Me Amazon here, and I want us to do a some sort of training. I don't know. I want to just give people the game to get money, man. So I'm pumped up about it.
That East Coast Circle of Greatness meetup.
Oh, listen, bro. It's going to happen, Reese. I ain't playing. Larry, I think he's in New York, so we got to get Posh out here. We're going to make it happen. Now, trust me. I'm pumped up about it.
You know, here's something that's pretty funny, Neo. I don't know if you know this, but Posh lives 2 blocks from my house. I could skateboard to her house, and we met through YouTube.
Yo, she told me, bro. We was talking. She said, "Yo, I didn't know. Reezy was like my neighbor." She told me. I'm like, "Whoa, are you kidding me? That's too much firepower on 1 block. Like, that's too much game on 1 block, yo."
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. So Reezy, we gonna do it.
To come out there and meet you, man. I've never been east of Kansas City, so I'm hyped.
Oh, bro, when I tell you we going to take care of you, bro, you don't even know. Like, my goal is to take care of my people. I already told Larry, you come out to Philly, photo shoot on me. We going to take care of you, bro.
Oh, so, we're going to have fun, man.
All right, now let's hop into it. I know this ranking, this is confusing for people. Tell us a little bit about Amazon ranking with products. I know one is the very best. You know, some ranks is a million. How can you tell about a product?
For Amazon, an item is designated a sales rank once it's sold. If it's never sold, it doesn't have a sales rank. So that number is going to indicate what place in line it is currently as far as the best seller or the worst seller. Number one is the best. The highest number is the worst one in the category. Amazon's website changes all the time, so I'm not exactly sure how to do it right now, but there's a way you can search in a certain category on Amazon to where it used to be you put open bracket, close bracket, and then just search for that, and it would show you the exact amount of items in a category. Then you could multiply that by 0.01 to find out what the top 1% is in that ranking, and then that's how I would go. But you could also get a rank table. People produce these rank tables that will tell you what the top 1% is in whatever category. We should have one on my Facebook group. There's a link to my Facebook group, which is free through my website, reezy.tv. But so the other thing that there's a huge misconception. A lot of people, I see people, they're like, I only buy sales ranks up to 700,000 or up to a million or whatever. And that's fine. Like, everybody could have your own tolerance for risk or how fast you want to turn over your dollar or whatever. But the thing that a lot of people don't realize is that rank is not static. Rank is always moving and always changing. So what happens is an item we'll start down here. Or let me go over here, see if I can figure this out. I hate doing this. So, because it's all reversed. Anyway, so the item will have...
You're welcome. If you were screen sharing, you could do that if you want to.
Yeah, no, it's all good. So the item will have, like, a sales rank, and it will be bad. And then it will sell, and it will spike, and it will go up and have a good rank. And then it will start to go bad again, right? It will start to go bad again. And it will sell, and it will spike again. It will start to go bad again. Every time it sells, it will spike. If it's a really hot-selling item, that thing will look like a freaking... a Richter graph, you know what I mean, or a lie detector test or something. That thing will be popping everywhere. And so to have a hard cutoff, you know, that item could be a million right now. It could sell one copy and then be 150,000 in 2 hours. So to have a hard cutoff doesn't really make too much sense. What you need to know is to view the whole picture of sales rank. So there's a website called keepa.com, K-E-E-P-A.com. There's another website called camel.com, three camels. And what these websites do is they track sales rank history over time. So you could look an Amazon item up on this website, and you can view the sales rank over time. And it's not like being a retail buyer, you know, for a store, or, you know what I mean, where you have to go, I think that sweater will sell, you know, 10 or 15, and we'll get 20 of those sweaters or whatever. Then you're left with half of them, and you have to clearance them. No. You can see the sales velocity. You can see this item sells like bananas. You can see, you know, you can look at the spikes and count them and be like, that's an approximation of how many sales are there. Obviously, the more dense the spikes are, they represent more than one sale for each spike. So you can't judge it exactly, but you can look at it and know that you're buying something that's actually going to move as long as you price it appropriately to the market value or whatever. So, yeah, sales rank, guys, is a beautiful thing, and basically just lets you know how popular an item is. FBA Scan has average sales rank, so we'll show you the average rank over the last 90 days, which is really cool as well. But for the most part, whenever you're unsure, you want to view that sales rank graph. There's a button on the – when you scan an item on FBA Scan, there's a little camel in the bottom left corner. If you press that, that opens right away to the camel screen, and you can view – the sales rank. And if you see an earthquake, rest assured that thing sells.
Wow. That's good. Jeez, my gosh. I'm sitting here taking notes. My gosh, I got the team in here taking notes.
Yeah, on the Instagram, someone reminded me is that there's Chrome extensions. So Keepa and Camel have Chrome extensions. So that's another little pro tip. If you don't know, there's a lot of cool little tools for Chrome browser. Go to the Chrome extension store and search Amazon or Amazon FBA or whatever you're looking for, and you'll probably find some cool extensions that can help you get your job done.
That's good. My God. So if we could quantify, right, the amount of game you just gave us, the amount of game out here, if you were to study Ron Hard for, like, you put 40 hours a weekend on research, I think you could have a successful business just based on all these tools you gave us. The amount of time that you're saving us with these resources is insane to me. It's insane. Yeah,
definitely. Like I said to you earlier, that if you go on my Instagram, I just wrote a little quick notepad and screenshot it, and I sent it to Neo too. I wrote it in a couple minutes, you know, in between innings, sitting on the bleachers at my daughter's softball game, but on the reel, that note has everything you need to succeed in Amazon. And it sounds kind of harsh or whatever, but if you have that note and you don't succeed in Amazon, it's your fault. You don't really want it. You know what I mean? Like E.T. says, you have to want the success as bad as you want to breathe. If you think you need 8 hours of sleep every night, you don't want success that bad. You know what I mean? You need to... like I told Neo, I can't sleep anymore, man. I sleep 5 hours a night, and I can't go back to sleep. I leap out of bed. I can't wait to start my takeover. Every day, someone calls, what are you doing, Reezy? Taking over the world. Same thing I do every day.
Wow, and that's crazy because I was texting Reezy. We was texting last night. It was 4 a.m. my time, 1 a.m. his time. This boy's still hustling. I'm still hustling.
This guy up at 4 a.m., 4 a.m.
This is what we do, man. I'm in bed already. This is what I do for my people. I'm really trying to see us be great, man. Everybody all around the world. So this is the game. What I want to do now, I want to open up the you know, I want to do like my Reezy resells. I want to open up the question for a live caller. Is that okay with you, Reezy? We'll do.
Yeah, let's do it,
live
man.
Callers, man. I know, guys. Listen, one of the things I talk about in my life is about under-promising and over-delivering. We all know this chat was only supposed to be an hour. We on an hour and 22 minutes, and this guy's just pouring his heart out. So whenever Reezy says it's over, we ending it. But until then, we're going to ask a few more questions, man, because this brother's going all the way in, man. And I just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. This is a game right here. So what are we going to do now? Let me see if we got a raise the hand type of thing on here. Let's see. Oh, and somebody drop a – for the people in our chat, drop a question in the chat. I'll answer them in the chat, and I'll try to unmute you. But I don't want to go in the process of unmuting all these people at once, and then it'll be just kind of too much. So if you got a question, drop it in the chat. Amanda, okay, we got Amanda, okay. Amanda, you can I'm going to unmute you now for your question. 1 second, please. Do-do-do. Are you on your webcam, Amanda, or no? Let's see.
No. Wait.
All right, cool. There you go. Answer your question. Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Hey there.
Reezy, can you hear me?
Hey. Yeah, we're good.
She's so a Reezy excited. Ninja. She's all Reezy, brother. Let's get it, man.
Hi, Reezy. I'm so excited. I listened to the call, as he mentioned before, with Posh a couple weeks ago. Then he told me, he's like, yo, I got a boy that's making all this money selling books on Amazon, and I went found you on there, and I got so excited. I immediately watched a few videos, and then I got my scanner. I'm scanning everything. I'm looking at my husband. He's in school. I'm like, well, you know what? The textbook, that's mine. So I'm really I'm like, don't mark it up too much. So I've been really hyped. I'm away on business right now, and I got to take the car out with my team, and I stopped by. I'm in Wisconsin. I stopped by a Goodwill and started scanning books for 30 minutes and got like over $250 in B250 deals, like in like 30 minutes. So thank you.
Yeah. I'm so hyped.
And I told the group, I was like, if anybody's in this area, go get it. But my question for you is just like around shipping. I know that you travel around to go and get different books. Like, do you ship individually from those different locations? Or do you take them home to clean them up first? How do you handle that?
Right. So I don't do a lot of traveling to source books where I won't be home with them myself. But I do travel. I go to Disneyland a lot, and I travel for softball for my daughter. We travel all over. One of the things I'm able to do through my success is my daughter's on a really high-level softball team that not only costs a lot but travels all over the U.S. or whatever. And so I try to take advantage of that and source stuff while we're traveling. And so I like to, if possible, bring, like, my office in a box with me if I'm driving, you know what I mean? Or if I try to pack really light so that I could have one backpack for office supplies. And I'll bring, you know, my printer, my laptop. Sometimes I try to bring a tape gun, some labels, you know. It just depends. Sometimes I can't fit certain stuff, and then I know I'll just buy a tape gun for $15 when I'm there or whatever. But, yeah, I run it out of the hotel. And sometimes, you know, you don't have a printer. The hotel has a printer. You know what I mean? Then you go grab some labels at Walmart or whatever. So at the very least, I always bring my scanner, even if I'm not planning to hustle. You know, I have my scanner. I have my rechargeable batteries. And but when I do plan it, yeah, I like to bring, you know, an office in a box and then just run the whole thing out of a hotel.
Awesome, thank you. Yeah, I was in my office printing labels, so, but I was just worried about, like, the cleanliness. And the other question I have is, can you briefly talk about just the conditioning of books?
Yeah, for sure. So, aside from the verbatim exact, like, what Amazon says, basically just follow those exactly. And if you're unsure, then make it down a condition. So if you think it's very good, but it might be good, then just make it good. Worst case scenario, you know, you're undergrading your books and you could make them better, but most times you're not making any more money by raising your condition. And so at least you're not going to under deliver. You know what I mean? Like we were just talking about, you want to over deliver. Amazon customers are really picky. It's not like an eBay customer. You know what I mean? They paid $70 a year to have Prime. They want it in 2 to 3 days. And, you know, sometimes a book is perfectly fine and someone's, like, complaining, and it's just, like, people have different perspectives of what condition is. So just err on the side of caution all the time.
Thank you.
That's good. That's great. Well, let's do one more. Let's do one more. Somebody drop their question below, and then we'll open it up for you. Also, what's the best printer to use? I know Dymo is probably one of the best ones. Would that be a suggestion?
So we use a bunch of different printers, but if you want to print FBA labels, which are the little labels you got to put on the products, or if you buy stuff from Amazon, you see it come with a little label on it, you're going to want to use the Dymo 450 printer. So you could use the Dymo 450 Turbo if you want. It just prints labels a little bit faster. Not necessary, but nice to have. And then there's other labels that you might need to print, or that you're going to need to print, the UPS label that goes on the box. Now, you could print it on a regular office printer. I prefer to use laser jets or whatever. Laser printers, not laser jet. Anyway,
you use laser printers because you don't have to pay for ink, correct?
Correct, yeah, they're pretty efficient. And so you could print it on that and then cut it and tape it onto the box, the postage label, which is like a 4x6 label, but much better and more efficient to have a 4-inch wide thermal printer that also doesn't use ink. And so that's the Dymo 4XL, or it's going to be a Zebra brand thermal printer that prints 4-inch labels. That way you print your shipping label and you just peel it and stick it. You don't have to cut it and tape it on. But, I mean, you can fully bootstrap this business, guys. I didn't really touch on that, but that's one of the main things that I want to tell you is that, like,
talk about that, Reezy, about bootstrapping. What is bootstrapping, Reezy? Because some people don't know what it is.
Bootstrapping means all you got is bootstraps. You know what I mean? You need a rope. All you got is bootstraps. You know what I mean? Twist those things together, and you got a rope. You know what I mean? Work with what you got. I don't know if that's the literal meaning of bootstraps. But
No. And it also means basically, you know, build your company with the money as it's coming in. A lot of us don't have. Some people can't invest $1,000, $2,000, $3,000 to get started, but you can invest your sweat equity. You can invest.
But when I first started Books, we weren't doing Fulfilled by Amazon. It hadn't actually opened that program yet, but we were a merchant fulfilling books, and this is just an example. You know, we didn't buy mailers or whatever. They're only like 15 or 20 cents or whatever, but we didn't have any money literally, so we would just go to the grocery store and grab a stack of brown bags. And I had a paper cutter, and I would just sit there, and I would disassemble paper bags to make brown packing paper, and I would have sheets of it, just rectangles and rectangles, and you would just take the book, roll it up in two rolls of brown paper, you know what I mean, and send it out. It's good. And if you want to make it happen, you can make it happen. You know, there's all kinds of things you can do. You don't need all the fancy equipment. You don't even need a computer. You can list books on Amazon using your phone. You know what I mean? You can figure it out. You could go to the library. You could go to your friend's house. There's no excuse. There's no excuse for you not to be online getting money. Like, if you're not online getting money, what are you doing? It's 2017. We got computers. We got internet. We got amazing people all over the place. You're still talking about the people that are geographically located near you and the opportunities that are right here, right there. And you don't understand that when I see someone fill out a job application, I see a caveman. That's what I see. That's the world that I live in, and that's like maybe I'm out on the forefield of it or whatever. That's where you need to be at. You need to be to where you think that job application. Why? There's so much opportunity. We're all great and amazing. Look what I did. Look what I did in 1 year. 1 year ago, Reezy Resells didn't exist. Who the heck is Reezy Resells? You know what I mean? Some guy who got on social media and started talking.
Wow. Wow, that's crazy. Listen, guys, and that brings it to one of my favorite things. I talk to my members all the time about this. Can you see me, Reezy? Because I'm doing a lot of my
good.
I talk to my members all the time about it's called execution over excuses. You can continue to talk about it, but when are you going to be about it? So if you're on this chat right now, I'm challenging you to do a little bit more than you talk about. I'm challenging you to go out here and make this thing work for you. He just gave you the game, literally, from A to Z. You have every tool. If we don't talk any more on this chat, he gave you the game to become successful. He gave you the game to grow. He gave you the game to get out your own way and make it work, guys. You are your job. You kill what you eat. I talk to a lot of my members and a lot of people about what it takes not to have a 9-to-5. Decide right now how much money you need to make just to survive. I'm not telling you to worry about what it's going to take for you to travel the world, what it's going to take for you to do things of leisure. No. How much money do you need to survive? Put that on paper and then go hustle. You can hustle the amount of money up to replace your job. And, guys, I'm telling you this because I did it. When I lost my 10th job 8 years ago, I said, yo, from this point on, I am mentally unemployable. I cannot be employed. You can't offer me a meal a year to do something I will not love. I will go out here and hustle, and I've been doing that ever since then. But once you make a decision, guys, you're going to come up with some strategies and ways to get money. My mentor be like, Neo, you always coming up with some ways to get some money. Yes, because I don't have a job. I got to provide for myself. I want to provide for my family. I want to inspire and encourage other people to do the exact same thing. But if I'm not hustling hard, if I'm not going in every single day, how can I tell someone else to do this? So when me and Reezy, primarily Reezy, giving you practical ways to get money online, you got to apply it, guys. Please don't disrespect yourself by not applying this information. Don't disrespect yourself by going in tomorrow and not using any of this information he gave you. And I'm not saying go quit your job because me and Reezy can't hire you at this second. But what I am saying is use this information right now to apply this to your future, guys. Start with making 100 a day, 50 a day, 30 a day. And it's only going to grow from there, but you must make a decision to start. And I challenge you, execution over excuses, and you will be successful, guys. I can assure you.
Speaking of your mentor, I want to give a big thank you to Eric because really, I like right now how I feel super passionate about social media and how I feel like, you know, I mean, everybody's great and amazing and anybody could do amazing things. You don't have to live this average life or whatever. And so, you know what I mean? When he says you got to want success as bad as you want to breathe. So I heard that message, you know what I mean? And it made sense to me, but it didn't really fully click until I also came upon Grant Cardone and started consuming his content and read his book, and I was like, yo, success is unlimited, and if you put that 10x effort, which means 10 times, that's what Grant talks about, 10 times more than the average person next to you, even when you stumble, you're still going to be 8 times ahead of everybody else, and that's what you have to do. You have to, success is unlimited, you have to want it as bad as you want to breathe, and you got to work 10 times harder than the man sitting next to you. And if you do that, there is no chance in, there's no way you're not going to succeed at whatever you really want to do. And those are the ways that you do it. So I can't talk to Grant Cardone or whatever, but you know Eric, so tell him I said thank you, and I would love to meet him someday.
Bro. And it's crazy. I just spent $1,000 on my Grant Cardone ticket. I'm in Miami March 18th through whatever. I spent $1,000 on it because I really want it, guys. I'm not talking about it. If I really want something, I'm going to put the money up and I'm going to put the work in to make sure I go get what I want, guys. So I'm challenging you. Don't get off this phone and let this be another phone call. We've been doing these phone calls for a while. That's why I fought people like Amanda who after Posh got off that phone, Monica, she's been working. She's grinding. She in Wisconsin grinding right now because of the information that she got from Monica and Reezy, guys. So please, you're doing a disservice to yourself if you don't execute. If you keep coming up with excuses, you don't really want it, guys.
It's not just hustling either, guys. I really want every one of you to know about the opportunity that's available through social media, right? Like, especially if you have time. If you're a kid, you have an immense amount of time. Get on social media and start using that to build your personal brand because you can monetize your passions and build a life doing things that you love doing and get paid doing it and help people. And the way you're going to do it is through social media. And I have a strong feeling that we're living in a bubble right now and that this bubble will not last forever. Right now, you can come up from the gutter on social media and not everybody knows how to do it. Gary Vee, content model, that's going to be the future. Everybody's going to be doing it. So in 2, 5, 10 years, whatever, next month, you might not be able to rise from the gutter on social media because day one, people are doing it with 2 filmers and an editor. The rich people are going to figure out social media and they're going to have it locked down, and average people like me and you aren't going to be able to rise to the top so easily because, like I said, they're going to have a whole production team behind them. Right now, you can just pull your camera out and put it in front of your face like, yo, what's good? It's Reezy Resells. I'm about to buy some stuff. And that resonates with people. But in the future, when they get used to this overproduced content, like reused to it, it's not going to work anymore. So please, guys, get on social media and do what you got to do because this time we're living in, it's going to be looked back at as a bubble. I promise you. My daughter right now, it's like the next Luna, she's 5, my youngest daughter. When she's like 15, every 15-year-old will have a personal brand. It's going to be insanely hard. but the ship hasn't sailed yet, guys. So get on social media. And it's not just for 15-year-olds, 20-year-olds, 25-year-olds. It's 30-year-olds. It's for Joe the Honest Mechanic. It's for the guy that can do credit repair. It's for the guy that wants to inspire people. It's for the guy that knows all kind of things about fishing or bowling or whatever it is that you know about and you're passionate about. There is people in the world that want to consume your content, and you can provide value to them through social media, and you will be a guy. Gary V told you what to do. Just give the game away. Give. Then you're the guy, and when you have to ask for something, you're going to get it. You know what I mean? Jab, 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 right hook, because we're entering the thank you economy. And if you don't have a personal brand, what are you doing?
Wow. And it's crazy, Reezy. I'll be telling my team, yo, go buy your domain. Hold on. Let me check this. Go buy your domain on GoDaddy. Get yourself a professional email. I tell them this simple stuff like, listen, your name will never go out of style. Buy your brand. Even if it's simply going on GoDaddy, $9.99, get your domain name because you are a brand. Look at that, Reezy Resells, ReezyResells.tv. Like, we're representing our brands, guys. Follow the hustle. We giving y'all the game.
I just bought 4 domains today, like over lunch. I'm telling you, if you have an idea, buy the domain. Worry about it later. Someone else is going to swoop up your domain and try to extort you.
Wow, that's crazy. So, guys, let's do 2 more questions from the audience, then we're going to end this call. We gave you a lot of game tonight, and I hope you're really applying it. So if you got a question right now, please drop it in the group so I can get you on here right now because I want to get you in. Please. Do not wait, and it should be one of my Circle of Greatness members. Y'all know I don't play with y'all when it comes to questions. When you got an expert on the line, you better ask away, because who knows when you're going to hear Reezy again on the phone. Who knows when we're going to get on personally to answer these questions. So if you got a question now, drop it right now in the group chat, and then or unlock yourself on the mute and ask the question right now, because time is running down, guys.
Real quick, while we have a little bit of dead air or whatever, I just want to let everyone know about an up-and-coming social media app that's pretty tight. There's actually 2 of them. One is Anchor. It's like audio for Twitter. Check that out. Gary V told me about that. And basically, it's 2-minute audio messages. They call them waves. You can leave your thought real quick, and then someone can reply to it. And so you can have a conversation. And it's crazy because I got to know people by their voice on Anchor, and then later followed them on Instagram and finally saw their picture or got a DM video from them. And that was just like a really trippy experience. But it's cool because you can just, you could drop your content real quick, like as if you were making a phone call, and then send it out. And then you could send it to Twitter or Facebook or put it on Instagram or whatever. So that's pretty tight. Another one is this app called IM8TV. And this thing is going to be huge, guys. It's like it's like Snapchat for selling stuff. So it's a social media platform that's based around the storytelling mode of making stories like Snapchat and Instagram. But every time you make a piece of content, you can put a link on it, and if the user swipes up after watching your content, they're going straight to Amazon to buy the item. So it's a great way to make extra money because you go and you sign up for Amazon affiliates, right? Then that's a way you can make money by suggesting Amazon products to people. It's free. Sign up for Amazon affiliates, write a blog, pepper it with links, whatever. Get your affiliate code from Amazon. You put it in the IM8TV app, and then when you link Amazon products, if people swipe up and buy it, then you get commission. You actually get commission for the next 24 hours of anything they buy off of Amazon, which is really, really huge. So, and it's really, like, it's worth paying attention to, and it's, like, at that precipice, kind of like how so, like, if you get on it, you know what I mean, and it pops, you could be the next DJ Khaled. You know what I mean? Don't forget that DJ Khaled really wasn't on Snapchat till like, October of 2015. And look at him now. He's at the White House Correspondents' Dinner.
Wow. Insane. Yo, social media can change your life. Reason, give us 3 ways to leverage social media, because a lot of, like you said, I'm on social media doing different things. I'm meeting new people. I'm building relationships.
Right.
I met with Andy Frisella off of social media, went in his DM, say, I want to get you on the call.
That's awesome.
I sent that message about 6 times till I got through. Not only did that get us a friendship, that also got us a $6,000 donation from him looking out. Reezy, Got in Reezy DM after I got on a call with Monica. Now yep. me and Reezy are going to be lifelong friends. We want to make money
like
together.
Me, that's a crazy trail right there, right? Gary Vee, I learned about Gary Vee. I don't know how I learned about Gary Vee. Gary Vee got me on social media. I started doing social media. Posh saw me on social media. Posh introduced me to you, and now here I am lacing the whole planet with game.
Yo, bro, it's crazy.
It's ridiculous.
But this is what we call leveraging social media properly. A lot of people are just consuming content that isn't helping their growth. Like, I unfollow people and things now that don't help me grow. Today in our private Facebook group, it's crazy. I mean, in our newsletter for COGA, we put Instagram pages to follow. Yours was one of them. Entrepreneur Mag was one of them. We're only putting things, content up that is good. Yeah. Like, I don't even want to be looking at content that's not inspiring me, helping me get money, or helping me serve, or just helping me get to the next level.
I feel you, man. My homie, he texted me the other day. He was like, hey, I'm going to be in town. You want to go out to dinner and talk money? And I was like, sure, but that's just called a talk. You know what I mean?
Yeah, listen. And that's crazy. Like, it's crazy, Reezy. It's a funny thing. Today I monitor who I spoke on the phone with. I literally spoke to at minimum 3 to 4 millionaires today who are my mentors. Nice. I spoke to you. I spoke to Watch Me Amazon via DM. I spoke to a couple other people through DM. I'm starting to see that my conversations are changing daily. Like, yep. I'm increasing the amount of people I'm talking to, but on a different level. I'm talking to people out here who are getting it, and eventually guess who's going to get it? Me, I'm going to be that millionaire. I'm going to be that $100,000 a month Amazon seller. Why? Because my friends do it, and I'm learning from you.
Right? You're the average of the people you
five people you hang around the most. I tell people all the time, you are the sum average of the five people you surround yourself with.
Yeah, that's what I struggle with that a lot, because I have a handful of really good friends from high school that I consider them family, really. And, you know what I mean? They're not all hustlers, you know? So it's like there's stress in our relationship because it's hard to hang out with me. Because I don't want to hang out. You know what I mean? Like, I want to be productive. And, like, it's like if they got to somehow trick me into drinking a beer, and then I know I'm worthless and I can't do any work, and then we can hang out and have a good time, which I actually like having a good time, but I'm just more focused on being productive because you only have so many seconds on this earth, you know what I mean? Not enough for me to do what I want to do, you know?
Yep, exactly. Wow, that's good. So, listen, guys, we're about to end it. Let's get 2 more questions from our audience. If y'all don't give me one, I have Reezy just get one from his live. But if I'm trying to get a live one. So, listen, you're now on, as Reezy say, you are now on the Neo Show with Reezy Resell. So y'all better get this question in right now. You can unmute yourself and ask the question. I don't know why people waiting so long, man. When you got somebody in here giving game, and I'm not quite understanding it. I want to ask one more time. Is someone ready to ask a question? Please do it now. Again, we got a few more minutes on the call. Get this game while you can get it. Unless we've probably covered all the questions. Let's get it.
So, let's
go. Hello. Hey, yes. This is Ron Green. It's Ron Green from Philadelphia.
Ron Green, I'm happy you on the phone, brother. Are you getting this heat, brother?
Man, I'm enjoying everything I'm hearing. I want to thank you for putting this together. I want to thank Reezy Resell for, pouring out his entire capacity of his brain tonight. You had me jotting notes the entire time, man. And
I appreciate you.
Thank you for tuning in, man, because as much as I like to talk, if no one's listening, I don't think I'm going to talk.
Right.
Oh. Yeah. So I wanted to ask if there was now I know you talked about a lot of different items that you've had success with, in the past. Is there anything right now that you could recommend, like that would be a good item to start with? For somebody like myself, I've never sold anything on Amazon. So, what would be something that would be like good for me to just
think? I recommend, just to give you an idea, Reezy.
He's in the clothing industry. He has a clothing company. Just to give you an idea.
Oh, and so you want me to frame my answer around your existing?
No, you don't. You don't have to. I was just giving you an idea of what he does.
Right, right. So you have physical goods. I would say if you have physical goods, you know what I mean, make an Amazon seller account, and then you have to, if you have your own products, you have to create product detail pages. And, you know, that involves taking pictures and following the rules. You have to have white backgrounds. The product has to take up 70% of the image, et cetera, et cetera. So it's going to be a little bit more work. You know, I don't like creating product detail pages, but that's
give us
the
a shortcut then. Forget that.
I mean, there's no shortcut to it. A lot of people actually, like, they'll be doing retail arbitrage and they'll scan something and it doesn't return a result. And so they move on to the next item. But the reality is that could be a gold mine and it's not listed on Amazon because it sells in the store or the store wouldn't buy it, right?
Right, right.
So then you have to go and make the product page and then, you know, you're the only one selling it until someone else scans it and finds it and, you know what I mean, drives the price down or whatever. So you got to learn Amazon. You could learn it with a lot of things. Books are really cheap to learn it. But if you have your own products, you're going to be listing your own products and creating product detail pages. Really, you just got to get on there, make an account, and start reading the help. Amazon has seller training videos. Amazon has a seller forum where probably almost every question has been answered. There's a ton of resources available to you as long as you have the drive to make it happen, you know? And if you get stuck, you know, come hit me up and I'll hit you back. I'm a little inundated on DMs, but if you message me on Anchor, like with a voice message, I'll reply like directly probably within 12 hours or less because I don't get very many messages on there. That's another pro tip. If you want to reach someone on social media, you should leverage your efforts to contact them on the platform that is the least popular that they use because you have less DMs that you're competing against.
That's good. That's a good word. That's good.
All right. Thank you very much. I appreciate your time. If anybody on the call is interested in, clothing line that helps you represent your culture, check out my clothing line, www.whatsupafrican.com. Thanks a lot.
I'm about to check that out. My sister-in-law is black, so she's down for all that good stuff.
Nice. Well, that's awesome, man.
I live in a surf town, and she's like, you know, she's like tore up. She ain't got nowhere to go get her hair did.
Oh man, I already know the struggle.
Oh, that's good. Yeah, but listen, man,
thank you for your time.
And listen, guys, really quickly, I love how Ron did that. He is a member of Circle of Greatness Academy, and everything I tell them to do, when you get on the phone, you get an opportunity to plug yourself. You plug yourself. Reezy might go check out his clothes and make buy some for his sister, but if he didn't get on the line and plug himself, guess what? Lost call. So next person, last question, unmute yourself, ask your question now.
Oh, Reezy, this is Devin Buchanan from Philadelphia. So, listen, my wife has been killing the game, and we've been back and forth, going back and forth. And as soon as you said it, I got that Casper book, PHL, on Instagram. So I'm going to be using that. But listen, so I want to try to figure out what do you feel is the best way to monetize, like a grassroots effort, because like I said, I'm in school, but also, you know, going to campus, handed out cards. Do you think it's better to take those books and put them on Amazon or try to sell them directly, you know, when book season comes back around?
I say sell them on Amazon, man. Your time is at such a preciousness. Like you said yourself, you're a student, so you don't have time to deal around with people because let's just assume that most of them were, you know, they came through when they said they were going to show up and they whatever. There's still going to be a lot of your time wasted, right? And that's a fairy tale. Half of them aren't even going to show up, even though they said they would. And you're going to spend time emailing them, et cetera, et cetera. So I say just sell them on Amazon.
Okay, cool. Focus
your time on sourcing products, you know what I mean? Not dealing with humans. Let Amazon deal with the humans.
Okay.
That's what they get paid for.
Absolutely.
Like when you sell on Amazon FBA, they do your customer service too. So I'll get emails oftentimes. I just send a boilerplate message that says, contact Amazon, here's the number, here's the email. And if I got a bad feedback or anything off of that, Amazon will erase it because it's their fault.
Ooh, gang.
Oh, wow.
Gems.
Wow.
Listen, guys, we got to save some. Thank you, Devin. We got to save some for when we bring Reezy to Philly for our Circle of Greatness members, man. We got to save a little bit of the game.
for real though, we should actually, whoever is in Philly that is actually sourcing stuff, or we could source stuff while we're there or whatever, but like actually send off a shipment to Amazon, you know what I mean, while we're there.
We're going to do that, and that's going to be with our members. Like, we're, Amanda, do you hear that, Amanda? I got my fiance on the phone, so she'll be in it. So she's in it, too. She's in your Facebook group, too, so we're in it. So listen, Reezy, I don't know if you know, like, I'm not sure. You know, you just met me, but I'm dead serious. So we're going to get you here in the next 30 days, and we're going to execute, because like everybody can see on my screen, saver execution over excuses. I'm not playing around.
Hey, do I get to go on a ski trip?
What'd you say, Reezy?
Do I get to go on the ski trip?
I would love. You know what's crazy? The ski trip is Sunday, and it ends Sunday. Like, the slopes close Sunday, so we got the last day of the year.
Nice.
So, but yeah, that's definitely happening. But listen, guys, hello. Man. Oh, somebody got a question before we close it out?
I just wanted to find out what was the name of the barcode scanner you talked about.
Okay, cool. So the one that I recommend everyone to use because they're super cheap is called Comtac, K-O-A-M-T-A-C, Comtac, and then the model number is KDC-200I, the letter I. You could get them, when I have them in stock, they're like $50 refurbished, and you could get them on eBay, I think maybe for like $10 more. I know there's some on there for $75.
Okay, thank you so much.
Don't wait for me. If you need a barcode scanner, go get one. Like, I don't care who you buy it from. You need one.
That's good.
Okay, thanks a lot. I appreciate it.
All right, have a good night.
Appreciate you, Reezy. So we closing it out with that, Reezy. If you could give our callers one piece of advice or one, you know, some word of encouragement, let's end it off with that.
Get on the internet. Get on Facebook. If you don't have Facebook, get on Facebook and get into the Facebook groups. The Facebook groups are the hidden gem of Facebook. All right, like there's a lot of. So get on Facebook. Go to that search and go to the groups tab. Search. Put in whatever you want to know about. Not just business related. But like if you're into knitting or you're into surfing or whatever, you could find people maybe even that live near you that are into what you're into, and or remotely or whatever. But you. Most importantly is you can find quality humans online. And even myself, like, I met so many quality humans in the last year. I'm only 32, but for a long time I've been kind of thinking that, you know, there's not a lot of quality people out there. It's hard for me to meet people. I pretty much gave up on meeting any new friends of mine. Like, you know, like, I got what I got, and that's it. No time for that. But online, I met a lot of cool humans that have taught me a lot of stuff that have helped me go to the next level. So networking, guys, like the thing is like, you know what I mean? Dating online is commonplace now. It was not too long ago where that was seemed weird to where like people thought your appendix might be missing when you go on an online date. Now it's normal. But you know what's still kind of not normal? Is meeting platonic friends on the internet or people that can help you do what you want to do, which is what friends are, right, in my opinion. And so, you know what I mean? You need to be swiping right for your networking, for your homies, for people that can help you do what you need to do because, you know what I mean, maybe the friends you got right now, they're not showing up on moving day. And you could meet some quality humans that will show up on moving day through the internet. So don't limit yourself to the resources that are geographically located near you. Because what's the chances are that the ones that you need or the people or the resources, whatever, what's the chances are they're near you? It's ridiculous. Like everything's crazy. Like, what's the chances are you would have been a human or that you were born during this time where the internet is coming up and there's all these opportunities and no one, you guys realize that's what the internet's doing right now. Right now we're in this revolution. Nobody knows how to do it. Everything changes every couple of years and most people act like the internet doesn't even exist. So if you follow people like Gary Vee, Andy Frisella, Grant Cardone, people who are in the top of their field on business, on social media, or whatever, you're going to be at the forefront. Like, I've only been doing social media for a year, and I already do $250 an hour consultations for social media. And that blows my mind. People consider me an expert, and I was just using it like a consumer a year ago. So don't be a consumer. the internet's not a television, guys. You don't need to just watch it, right? When we were kids, that's all we could do. We could sit in front of it and it would hit us, right? Mm. We could hit people now. So push back. Don't let it hit you. That's what they want you to do, is to just sit there. Push back. Distribute content, broadcast. Let the world know who you are, you know what I mean? Don't just exist, you know what I mean? Like, create.
Wow. Yo, Reezy, I'm sitting here amazed, bro. You giving the game. So, guys, listen, man, we had my guy long enough on this chat. He gave the game. He gave his heart. Reezy, we only supposed to go 45 to an hour. We went 2 hours, bro. I love you. I appreciate you. I want to say thank you. One, I know you, like you said, you don't have any programs, no anything, but how can, if somebody want to pay for the $250 social media training, how can you do so?
Just hit me up, reezyresales@gmail.com. I do, gotcha. I'll do a special promo, $100 for a half hour for anybody in the Circle of Greatness if they want that. Mm-hmm. And yep. So just hit me up for that and let me know that it was from the Circle of Greatness and we can do that. But really, sure I don't want you to call me for a consultation. You don't need to consult me. All that information is available for free. If you're calling me, it's because you have money and you don't have time and you want a fast track and you're going to buy your way into it. And that's what you're going to do. People who have money and don't have time, they know you can do that. I grew up poor. I didn't know you could do that, right? So if you want to do that, we can do that. Otherwise, just do me a favor and buy my book when it comes out. Should be coming out this year.
Oh, listen, Reezy, we going to buy all them books, and we going to do the exact thing that you do with Gary Vee book. We gifting them bad boys. So I cannot wait until that happens. Reezy, send me the address. You getting a book. You getting an extra.
Hey, don't forget about those Nintendo Switches. Someone's getting a Gary Vee book.
Yo, Troy, find out what store is open. We're going to go buy them 2-3 Nintendo Switches tonight. Hey, 12 o'clock midnight.
Hey, don't front. I'm going to check your story.
Listen, I ain't fronting, Reezy. I ain't book. I got my assistant right now looking it up now. We about to find where to get it from. So listen, guys, man. Again, Reezy, I love you, brother. I appreciate you. We're going to put the logistics together in the next 7 days. We're going to get you here. In closing, guys, I'm going to hang out. But please, join CircleOfGreatnessAcademy.com. Get into our private network so we can help you grow personally and professionally. Remember, we're a community that supports you being in business for yourself, but not by yourself. Click the link in my bio. First 7 days is free. Thank you, Reezy. We love you, brother. And look forward to getting you here to Philly in the next 30 days. Mark my words on that, brother. Thank you.
Awesome, man. I can't wait.
Yep. Thank you, brother. Talk to you in a bit, man.
All right. See you later.
Wow, guys. All I could say is wow, 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 wow. My man Reezy Resells just gave us the game. Like, I don't know. I don't know if it's either you don't want it bad enough or you're not willing to execute. This man just gave us everything we need to know to be successful. He gave us everything we need to know within 2 hours for you to go from not having a job, for you having a job, to not having a job. He gave you everything to really start being a part-time hustler, guys. Amazon, he gave us A, B, C. He gave us too much game. Like, people are DMing me like, yo, this boy really giving me the game. He is major all the content that he's giving us. So we got to value people like Reezy. When this man book come out, I'm making sure every member of COGA has to buy it. That's a recommended reading. Whatever course he's selling, we got to buy it because this man is giving his heart. He's giving the game for us, man. And the only way we can show our love back to him is making sure we support him. And for those who know me, y'all know one thing about me. If I say something, I'm going to go get it. I have no other opportunity. So we bringing Reezy to town. Watch it. Watch it happen in the next 30 days. Y'all be like, Neil, you sure? I'm dead serious, guys. So, again, for everybody who want to call, man, I just want to say thank you. I hope you really got something out the call, man, because I know I did. I'm praying to God that we hit the record button right, because I'm going to go back and listen over again.
I cannot wait to get to Philly and hook up with my boy Neo and take the red pill.
Oh, it's happening, brother. It is happening.
We're going into the Matrix, because I'm going to tell you right now, man, I feel like I can see the code. That's like, I kind of want to explain that. Like, in the last few months, my passion got so sparked that's how I feel every day I wake up. I feel like I'm in the Matrix and I can see the code. And everyone else that just wastes all their precious time, it doesn't make any sense to me.
Mm. Wow. Listen, game. He give look. He posted hung up. He's still here giving game.
I gotta go though. I gotta go to the restroom so bad.
Go ahead, Reezy. We will talk to you later. I'm gonna keep it up. But talk to you later, bro. Appreciate you, bro. Thank you, bro. Hey man, guys, I'm super pumped up. By a show of hands in the comment section, let me know how many COGA members are left on the chat. Just drop a message in the chat. Let me know how many COGA members we got in the chat, and let me know how many members who are going to actually join tonight. If you're watching my stream, you can sign up right now. Your next 7 days is totally for free. Get involved with our group. We are a community that supports you being in business for yourself, but not by yourself. And if you're dead serious about growing, if you're dead serious about getting to the next level, I advise you to sign up for the whole year. Don't play with this thing if you're really ready to get to the next level. I'm bringing Reezy to town, and in the next 30 days, we're going to release this thing so soon. But I'm telling you, you better get involved. You better get down with the program, because we're about to grow. We're about to evolve, and we're about to get to the next level. Find out where we could get 3 switches from tonight. 12 p.m. midnight, we want to go buy some switches. How much are they? We buying 3 of them. We buying 3 switches tonight. My man gave us the game. We're about to get there in a minute. My man gave us the game, guys. How many people still in the chat? Can y'all still hear me? Can y'all still see me? How many people still in the chat? Amanda, you still here? Rashida, you still here? P. Michael, you here? We got the boss lady, DeVita, here. We got Devin here. How many members is left in the chat? And if you're not a member, click the link in my bio right now. You need to become a member. You need to get involved. We're about to go to the next level, guys, and you do not want to get left out, because trust me, some things are only for members, and if you're not a member, you just can't get down. So please make sure you're a part of it, guys. And right now, I'm about to open up the chat for all my members. We're about to just talk about the chat ourselves. But I hope y'all got some gems and some jewels out this call. But trust me, if you're not a member, get down right now. But I'm opening up the